What is the best investment in the time of coronavirus? Coming up. Hi everyone, this is Ernesto from Attaboy Cowboy, and on this channel we give you health and wealth tips to help you be more successful. Now I've had a few people ask me, hey, what is the best investment right now? You know, stocks are going down, interest rates are low, what should I be putting my money into? And I'm gonna go back to one of my tried and true investments that has been very, very successful for me. One thing you want to look at is when there's a lot of uncertainty, that increases the risk. Because remember, one of the most basic things I learned when I was studying economics in business school is that everyone that looks at, you know, all those numbers in the business page, all those numbers and those graphs and all this other complicated stuff, most people think it all comes down to numbers and some type of science. And the reality of it is that most of economics and a lot of the stuff we do in personal finance and finance is based on emotion. It's not based on science. Sure, for the people that really know what's going on, the bankers, the economists, the, you know, financiers, they look at a lot of that, those numbers, and they help. But for 98% of people, 99%, they go based on instincts and on feelings. And that's why you might hear one of the most important indicators they're always talking about on the news and on the business articles, everything else, is consumer sentiment. How does a consumer feel? Do they feel like spending or they feel like saving? Let me give you an example. Let's say, like right now, for example, we have the coronavirus. People are scared. So they're thinking, man, look at the stock market's going down. All the markets are going down. You know what? I'm going to sell my Apple stock, my Ford stock, my Microsoft stock. I'm going to save my money and wait and see what happens because I don't want to lose all my money in an economic downturn. And people start doing the same thing in everything. They start doing what's called retrenching. When it comes to businesses, they say, you know what? Instead of building that new plant or that new warehouse, I'm going to hold back. I'm not going to invest the money. Let me see how things kind of play out. And depending on how things play out, I'll decide whether or not I want to make the investment or I want to hold back because I don't want to lose my money. Remember, nobody wants to lose their money. But if all of a sudden next week someone announces, hey, we found a cure for the coronavirus, it's available, everybody's going to be euphoric, going to be happy. Everybody's going to say, hey, you know what? Stock market's going to go up. I'm going to buy some stock. So you bet your bottom dollar, everybody's going to pile their money into Microsoft, Uber, Google, Apple, all these big companies so they can try to benefit from the stock market increase. So that's a good example of consumer sentiment. When people don't feel good or they feel scared, they're gonna sell their investments or they're not gonna make the investments. When they feel good and they're feeling confident, they're gonna spend money. They're gonna buy products, gonna grow their companies, families gonna go out and buy new cars, they're gonna buy a bigger home, all that kind of stuff. So the bottom line is that economics and personal finance, you really do have to look at consumer sentiment, how people are feeling. So back to the question, what is the best investment? Well, what is the least risk averse? You know, you can buy gold or silver or something like that. Those things are gonna go up and down. Same thing with emotions. So one of the best investments you can make is right here next to me. These are solar inverters for homes. And I'm talking about installing solar panels in your home. Now, some of you have heard me talk about this before. And why am I mentioning it again? Well, let me break it down really easy because I get a lot of people still asking me the same question. So I'm gonna give you bit by bit the numbers. So I'm gonna give you an example here in Los Angeles. I was talking to one of my buddies and he just got a bid for $10,000 to install solar panels on his house. And many of you may say, well, hey, you know what? I don't have $10,000. Well, you can get balance transfers, you can finance it, you can lease it. In a lot of states, especially California, they give you no interest loans to buy those solar panels. Now, how much could you make on a $10,000 solar panel installation? And remember, California is one of the most expensive states. We have one of the higher labor costs. We have a lot of regulations. A lot of things are expensive here. So if you live in other states, the numbers are much more favorable in your favor. So here in California, in Los Angeles, for example, a system that would take about $10,000 to install is going to save my friend $150 a month electricity. Now, how much is that in a year? Well, it's $1,800. And that's about 18% if you look at it. If you look at investments, a really solid investment is going to give you 5 to 7%. So that would be $500 to $700 in a year. Now, if you're talking about something that's just awesome, just a great investment, you're talking about like 10%. That would be about $1,000. And like I said, this is $1,800 right here, easy. And these systems come guaranteed for about 25 years. So the payback without any incentives, without any tax credits on a $10,000 system is about 6 years. 6 years, you're gonna get all your money back. And after that, you're just gonna be making $1,800 a year profit. In the United States right now, they give you a 30% federal credit. So that drops it from 10,000 to 7,000. In California, they give you about a 20% credit additional for state taxes, that brings it down to $5,000. And the county you live in or the city, they give you rebates. Right now in LA, it's about $1,000. They've cut it down quite a bit because it's such a good deal. So that brings our total cost down to $4,000 from $10,000. Now, if your system's costing you $4,000, you can then write that off on your taxes if it's an investment property. So if it's investment property, you take another 30% off that. That's $1,200 off the $4,000. You end up with $2,800. Now, how long will it take you to make back $2,800 if you install the system? Well, if you're making $1,800 a year, you're talking about a year and a half, about 18 to 19 months, that's nothing. And after that, you're making money for the rest of your life or the next 25 years. One of my friends was asking me, how dependable are they? Well, in our projects, we're making about $6,000 to $7,000 a month on solar panels. That's how much we're making. Now, if you calculate that in a year, that's $6,000 is $72,000 a year. $7,000 is $74,000. That's like a teacher's salary. That's how much we're making additional a year, like a teacher's salary, just by installing solar panels and having passive income every month. Now, I have these here because one of my inverters, this is what converts the electricity coming from the roof to the usable electricity you can use in the house. And I should know this because I'm studying solar panel installation right now, but I believe it's DC in the roof, I forgot, and AC in the house. But this is a converter, it converts it. And just to give you an idea how light this is, it doesn't weigh very much, but this inverter costs about $1,200, but it comes with like a 10-year warranty. So mine were a few years old and I'm not sure what happened, but it wasn't producing electricity anymore, it burned out. I contacted the company and they just mailed me a new one. Zero cost, I didn't have to pay for shipping or anything. Now, this is another inverter, this is called an Aurora. This one's actually really heavy. I need another person here to lift this up. And this is a 5 kilowatt inverter, and this is for a house that we have that has two old inverters. They're about 18 years old and they're actually working just fine. They're pretty old and they're working. But this one's a lot more efficient and I got it on a crazy deal. It's worth about $2,000. I found that on eBay for a guy for $500. I did the numbers because of the increased efficiency, because this one's so much better. The payback will be a few months. It'll be like 6 months I'll get the money back for it. And again, it's a brand new inverter. It's never been used. This is called an Aurora. So these are some of my best investment strategies. And I have friends that are investors, real estate investors, doctors, therapists, all sorts of people. They're very educated. And they love to talk about personal finance with me. And for some reason, they just don't get it. And I think that's normal. A lot of times when things are really simple and really obvious, we don't do them. So this is a simple investment. If you're looking for something, you don't have to hit home runs all the time. You can hit a series of base hits and still win the baseball game, like the Dodgers, right? But this is a guaranteed money maker. Everybody needs electricity. Let me give you another positive about buying solar panels. Now, most things go up in price every year because of inflation. Well, electric bills go up every year. Right now, we're making $1,800 a year with this box. But every year in the city of LA, it varies. Your prices could go up 3 to 7% a year. So let's say it goes up 5% this year, your electric bill. This is still going to be making that same amount of electricity. So what's 5% of $1,800? Well, it's about $90 you're gonna be making. So you're gonna be making almost an extra $100. And then the next year, electricity goes up another 5%. So you make another about $95, $100. Remember, this is compounding. So this is the cool thing. It's actually like a compound investment. You're making 91 year, 100, 110, 120, 140, 180. It compounds over time. It's gonna be compounding for the next 25 years to 30 years, the life of the system. You're gonna be making 3 to 5% extra every year. So I'm saying $1,800 a year, in 10 years you'll make $18,000 in about 30 years, which is the normal expected life expectancy of one of these systems. 18 times 3 is about 54,000. You're gonna make about $54,000 off this system that you paid $10,000 for. Plus, it went up 3 to 7% every year for those 30 years. So it's really not gonna be around 54. It's probably gonna be around $60,000 to $70,000 you're gonna make on this system. Let's say 60, that's a little more realistic. So if you invested $10,000, you're probably gonna make about $60,000 on electricity. Plus, if you have all those tax credits I mentioned, this system could come out to costing you about $4,000 or less, $3,800. So I don't know, you tell me, is it worth it to spend about $3,800 to make about $60,000 and help out with the environment, increase your property value? I mean, the benefits are exponential. There's just so many good reasons to do it. I, for one, live in Los Angeles, and I like breathing clean air. I like having clean oceans. I like looking up the sky and seeing it clean. Well, if I'm running all my appliances and I'm not installing solar panels, guess what? I don't have any say over what is being used to make that electricity. It could be natural gas, it could be nuclear, it could be coal, and some of those things are not good for the environment. They can do a lot of environmental damage. So when I'm walking outside and I'm saying, hey, the sky is so smoggy here in LA, what the heck, why don't they do something about it? Well, how about I do something about it? How about I install some solar panels? And everybody that installs them, they help cut down all those carbon dioxide emissions and all that particulate matter in the air, and less people are having allergies, less people are having asthma attacks, we have less hazy skies, I mean, the city isn't as hot, we help cut down global warming. It's just a multitude of benefits. So again, if you haven't considered it, please consider installing solar panels on your home. It's an awesome investment. In the time of coronavirus or any other time, if you have some extra cash sitting on the sideline because you're afraid to put it into the stock market, afraid to buy real estate, that's very wise. It's probably a good time to just sit it out, but this is going to be good anytime, and it only gets better every year. So consider putting one of these on your roof. Thank you for listening, and if you have any questions, please comment below. Thank you.